Yo, what up? It's Food for Thought Thursday. It's the last day of the month. We're getting ready to head into February. So today I just want to hit you up with a couple little things to prepare you to get to the next month. Some things that you can take on to continue to get better and grow coming into February. First, I just want to start off with a story. So the other day I'm eating some shrimp chow mein. Slam it, right? I'm watching one of my shows. And I go to take another bite. And when I look down to go to take another bite, I'm looking for a piece of shrimp. And I'm like, what? That's it? Like, where did it go? Like, I ate it all already? And after that, I wanted it so bad. And when I didn't have it anymore, I had a thought. And the thought was, if I would have known my last one was my last one, I would have ate it slower. I would have cut it into thirds. I would have cherished it more. Or I would have done something to make it last longer. Or I would have savored it. Or I would have appreciated it more. But I didn't know it was my last one. Now, we can have this mindset when it comes to food and to shrimp, because shrimp is amazing. Or we can take that mindset and put it into real life. As in, if I would have known that this would have been my last basketball game, or if I would have known that this would have been my last day to see someone, or my last whatever. We have to go in and approach life in every situation as if it is our last, because we don't know. We might just be so busy moving around, hanging out with our friends, on the grind, doing all types of things, and then we'll stop and realize that was my last one, and you didn't know. And maybe you're gonna regret that you didn't cherish it. You're gonna regret that you didn't savor it, or that you didn't cut it into thirds, or that you didn't even realize. Because when it comes to life, we don't really know when it will be our last, or our last whatever. When it comes to playing sports, you never really know when or if you're gonna get injured, or what might happen to the season, or anything like that. And I'm not saying any of this to scare anybody. I'm saying this so that way we can start to cherish it is what we have, because we can get caught up in the mindset as, oh yeah, I got this, I'm living, I'm doing whatever. And we can live cocky as if every single day is guaranteed, but it's not. You know, we can live cocky as if every game is guaranteed, as if every person in our life is guaranteed, but it's not. And they're not. So we have to be able to cherish everybody, because it's so easy to get caught up into ourselves and caught up into our own lives that we forget to see and cherish the people and the friends that we have around us, that we look back and it's like, shoot, what happened to that friendship? And that's not something that you want to do, because we weren't created to live life solo. And I'll get into more of that in February, but right now I just want to focus on the mindset. One thing that I want to talk about today is the mindset of being confident. Okay, so we talked about the mindset of fear. We talked about the mindset of jealousy. But right now, as we're getting ready to head into the rest of the year, I want to talk about the mindset of being confident. And so you can see right here, I got my TCSA gear on. Hit me up if you need some. But one thing that I say is right to confidence. And in order to be confident when it comes to your craft, on the basketball court, the football field, whatever it is that you play, you gotta work. You gotta put in the work. You gotta get in the gym. You gotta get on the field. You have to commit yourself to work, okay? Because there's a difference between being cocky and being confident, okay? The confident person, they're not swayed by anybody else. They don't really compete so much with others as much as they compete with themselves and try to make themselves better. But the cocky person is an insecure person. The confident person is like, shoot, I'm just out here trying to grind. I'm just out here trying to get mine. And it builds up, okay? You work so hard that when you step out on the court, you're like, shoot, I've done this a million times. I've taken this shot a million times. I've hit this crossover a million times. It's nothing. You know, I don't have to sweat it. I don't have to try to get ready now, because I've been ready. I was born ready. I prepared myself. And your confidence comes from your preparation. Okay, but then on the flip side, your right to confidence in Christ, it's your birthright. It is our birthright to be confident in Christ, because he died so that way I can be confident in him. He died so I don't have to look to my left or to my right and wonder, who am I? Where is my self-worth? How do I know who I am and figure things out in life? It's through Christ. Okay, so it's our birthright to be confident in him. He died so that way you can say, I am Arisa. I was born this way to be who I am and live out, and he gave me a passion, and he gave me dreams, and he will fulfill them. They will come to pass. Okay, so I don't have to worry about what other people say about me. I don't have to focus on other people's comments and the naysayers and everybody else who wants to hate. I can focus on who it is that God created me to be and be confident in that. And as long as your confidence lies in Christ, you're going to be good to go, because he's the one thing that's unshakable. He's the one thing that is consistent. He's the one thing that will always be there for you, no matter what, on your good days and on your bad days. He's the one thing that will never fail you. So if he says that you can be confident in who you are, bump what anybody else has to say. Okay, so as we're getting ready to head into the rest of this year, you're trying to figure out, you know, what it is that I want to do. Have you even stayed up with your goals that you set 30 days ago? Or have you fallen off? And if you have, get back on. Okay, so we want to be confident. We want to cherish every moment and every day that it is that we have. A lot of us are graduating, like myself, and so it's hard for me to be able to focus on certain things and to cherish a lot of things, because I'm so focused on the end result that I have a hard time focusing on the present and focusing on certain people that are around me and cherishing the friendship. So that's one thing that I have to call myself out on and say, hey, cherish these people that are around you right now, because they might not be here for long. You don't know what the next step of your life looks like or theirs, and you don't really know what tomorrow looks like. So don't live so much in the future, because soon your present will be your past. And you don't want to go into the future regretting. And so I'm calling you out to focus on those people, to cherish those people, to cherish the times. I'm coming into my season and I only have 5 games left. And that, to me, is overwhelming. And so that's one thing that I really want to cherish it. I really want to cherish my teammates and my coaches and the opportunity that God has given me for the past 5 years to play this game that I love. And so wherever it is that you are in life, whatever it is that you're doing, whether you're just starting college or just starting high school, or whether you're finishing, or whether you're an adult and you have kids, cherish them. Cherish every last second that you have. Cherish every last day that you have. But then be confident. Build your kids up in confidence. Build yourself up in confidence. Don't tell yourself that, no, I can't do this, or I'm not good enough, I'm not smart enough. If you don't feel you're smart enough, then go figure it out. Go learn about it. Okay, we gotta start getting hungry for knowledge. So, Food for Thought Thursday, just a little things that I just want to give out. Make sure you come back Saturday, February 2nd. I have a special video coming out. You don't wanna miss it. Like I said, I wanna be real transparent with you all. So, hit me up next week. Food for Thought Thursday. Make sure you hit me up for some TCSA gear coming to you soon. February is the month of love, and we'll be getting into it for sure. It's your girl, Fresh. Love you. Peace.